भाई है क्या बाइक चला रहा है भाई।
Saviri Sapa in the morning. It's around 6:30 and look at the environment around. It's very cold. The temperature is around 2-3 degrees Celsius. And we met someone. We met Zuzu. And we will be going to her house and we'll be trekking to some remote area of Vietnam-China border. So we are thinking to take a package. It's around $30. We'll take a bike from here to her village. We'll do some trek and it includes 4-time meal, night sleeping. And tomorrow morning we'll get a bike and come back here and leave for maybe Hanoi. So see you. So this is the kind of bike we have to go. So we are getting 3 bikes for 3 people. They are taking us. This is my bike. What's your name?
Honey.
Honey. Kamal. Zuzu house, which is our breakfast point. It's in middle of nowhere. So cold here, full of fog. The route was so amazing. We can see that paddy and rice field out there. So we'll have breakfast here. I'll just show you how
the house. This is the house. It's a small village.
Waiting for breakfast, sir. They all are hungry, it seems.
They got invited late.
So we are done with our breakfast. They gave us pancakes with cream and banana. Now we'll be going for some small trek. So we have our bags with us. And maybe we are not sure if we are staying in this house or maybe we'll go to some other house and we'll stay there. The kids are here are so cute.
Dude.
So we're starting the trek now. See these ducklings. Such cute creature. Okay, we reached the house that we are supposed to reach. The place where we are staying, the lady is 16 years old and she is married. So we came to know that. The girls and guys in Sapa, they get married very early during the New Year time. They are allowed to pick their husband, wife, and it's like we only thought like in Rajasthan we have child marriage, but this is like also like child marriage.
How did you meet your husband?
I met his Sabatham.
You went there? Then?
Yeah. I met his Sabatham. I met his wife, like, the girlfriend of her trainer. I like him, he likes me. He like his mother, father, talk to him.
Okay.
Talk to my mother, father.
Okay.
So she's telling she went to the main Sapa town, then she met the guy and their parents had a talk and then decided to get married. Very simple.
How old are you?
So she's 21 and she's also married and have a baby as well. Two baby.
You have two baby?
Where is the other baby?
You can't guess the age of the girls here. Seriously, sometimes you think, okay, she's a very small girl, it turns out she's 21. So we left from this house. Now we are trekking to some other place where we'll have our lunch. So we have kept our bags there. So now we are very comfortable trekking. We have to trek for around 2 hours now. And it's still misty. It's around 11:30, 12. But still we can't see the sun. Famous for its rice field, but we can't see anything because of this mist and fog.
Yes.
If you Google the images for Sapa, you'll find lush green outfields of rice field, paddy and all, but due to this weather we can't see anything. So now time to change the kid. No, not change the kid. So earlier this small girl, she's of 8 years, she was carrying her brother, sister. Now the mother will be carrying. So we found a shop where we get sugarcane. Ganna, apna desi. So we are trying. And this is for 2000 dong. So in currency it will be around. Yeah, 2000 for whole ganna, like this big, this one. So Indian currency is around 5 rupees. Pretty cheap, right? Taste is also similar. So we are just going towards one waterfall and then suddenly an old lady came and she spanked Anoop and me. I don't know why. She suddenly came to us and she spanked us. These are the rice fields I was talking about, but it's not looking that green because it's misty. There's no sun out here, but it's looking amazing. Yeah. Wow. We're about to reach the waterfall. It is there on the top. Before this we have to crisscross this bridge. Beer is everywhere in Vietnam and it's very cheap. Ooh, hanging bridge. See that bridge? Right. Wooden.
Sahi.
The waterfall, and there's a small bridge, we can go there. No, this bridge. Okay.
Yeah.
We finally reached the waterfall spot. The small waterfall. Nothing special about it. The small bridge here. The fun part of seeing this waterfall was the trek to reach here. It's a small waterfall and there's a little bit, you can like swim here, but it's damn cold, so we're not trying to go inside the water. And it's around 2 o'clock now, I'm very much hungry, so maybe we'll leave from here in next 5 to 10 minutes and we'll go to our next stop where we'll have our lunch. We can't pronounce the name, so we'll see and tell you. So we reached at some small cafe, here we'll be having our lunch. And of course, we are because very cheap in Vietnam. But chicken noodles and something veg. And vegetarian noodles. So I have to see, wait and see how it is. Final food arrived.
Hey. Hey. What?
Put the sauce. What is good? We got some fruits as well. So we are back at our homestay and it's getting a little cold now. So Prerna is having green tea and we are helping the lady with this potato leaves. And with us, we have Julia from Germany. She's been to Bangalore, so we'll catch up soon. And Laura, and of course Anup. So for dinner, I think we'll be having some chicken because they gave option for pork and chicken. So we're going with chicken for sure. And then that's it. We'll for the day. And tomorrow maybe we'll be going to Hanoi and then Ha Long Bay in the morning. So this is the end for Sapa trip for us. We just have to relax here now. And it was a wonderful experience in Sapa. So
yes.
If you like mountains, greenery and all, you should definitely come to Sapa.
Good morning, it's day 4 and we are leaving from our Zuzu homestay and going to Sapa bus stand now. We'll be leaving for Ha Long Bay now. It will be around 9 to 10 hours of journey and I don't know why this dog is barking at me. So we are taking a bike from here, bike taxi. For reaching Sapa bus stand, it will take around 30-40 minutes. Then the bus journey is around 9 to 10 hours, which will be going via Hanoi. So the homestay where we are staying was very nice. I'll give the number of the homestay here. You can see around here. And if ever you are coming to Sapa, you can just call to Zuzu, who is the owner of the homestay, and she can arrange everything for you. So we got 4 times four. And we're sleeping for the night and two treks, okay, and we paid around $30. It was all worth it. So whenever you're coming here, just try. Bhaiya kya bike chala raha hai bhai, 10 feet 15 feet ki visibility aur bhai apna Valentino Rossi hai. We can't literally see anything, but this is like very crazy. See my bike. Bhai, ye log agar racing pe aa gaye na, to bhai hara denge sabko. So we reached Sapa town. It was a 30-40 minute of, I don't know what kind of biking, but these guys are pro, definitely pro in the biking. If they are competing in a competition, definitely they will. But the visibility is around 10 to 15 meters and they were driving like crazy. Like we both were struggling to hold on our seats.
Too cold and, yes, too dangerous and too cold.
Too dangerous. Seriously.
It was raining also and too much fog. We can't see anything on the road.
But
yeah, we trusted our guy and we are here fine.
I think for the guys like this, Ladakh and Spiti will be like a piece of cake. The way they were driving, oh my god. And the bike they have is already only 150cc. Now we booked our tickets from Hanoi. For per person we are paying around 4 lakh 50 dong, 50,000 dong. That's Indian currency of 1200 rupees. So it will be a 9 to 10 hour of journey. So we'll try to show you on the way how the route looks like, and then we'll see you in Halong Bay. We are inside the bus now for Halong Bay, and this is how the bus looks like. So these are the seats. So they have this semi-sleeper seats, and they have two floors. And seats are in the side, like this, middle, and again side. So we're paying around 1200 for this. So we are some 80 kilometers shy from Hanoi, and stopped midway for lunch. So this is how a normal roadside dhaba of Vietnam looks like. It's pretty big though. Pretty clean it is. And this is the food we ordered. Egg fried, something egg fried, and chicken rice. So this is our bus. They put a bike inside the bus. So you're not allowed to wear your shoes and chappals inside the bus. You have to keep them in a poly bag, and they will give you a different plastic chappal if you want to go outside. Pretty nice. That's why the buses are too clean.